Hey everybody, it's Moonbow here, and welcome back to more Endless Scrap Mechanic. So today's video is all about doors, those things that you use to go from one space to another. And with the release of Scrap Mechanic Survival around the corner, I figured we're going to be building bases, we're going to be building vehicles, and no doubt they are all going to be using doors. So I decided to push my creativity with door making, which is something I've never really done before, and I have created a long hallway with a lot of really cool and interesting doors that we're going to be taking a look at to maybe inspire some creativity in your own door making. So this is the Great Hall of Doors. We're going to be taking a look at all of them, and I'm going to kind of pick them apart as well to show you how I've built certain ones. Some of them are more complicated than others, but they are definitely all different and unique in their own way. Now, after the video though, let me know in the comments which door was your favorite. Alright, so here we are at door number one. So we're gonna start things off a little slowly here. This is a simpler door than the rest of them, but if we press the switch, you'll see it in action. There it goes. It is your simple vertical sliding door. There it is going down. So this is a pretty standard door design. It might not be the most crazy or unique design when it comes to doors, but this is something that you might not have considered before, and I think it's a very nice, sleek design. Now, the way this door works is obviously quite simple. On the top of it there is a single piston attached to the door itself. So when you press this switch right here, the piston actions and it pushes the door back down to the ground again. So this is, like I said, a very simple door, but you can close it from the other side as well. Now, if you guys don't know how to do that, that's a very simple thing to do using a single logic gate and two switches. So you got one switch on one side, the other one here. You put it to a logic gate just like so, and then you put it to the XOR, which basically makes it so that it's active if only one of the link triggers is active. And that works perfectly for a door with switches on both sides. Now it's time for door number two. This one actually might have taken me some of the most time out of all of these doors to make. It's really cool though. So I'm just gonna press the switch so you guys can see what it looks like, and then I will break it down. So here we go. Oh yeah. There it goes. And then it breaks open. That's a pretty interesting door. These doors don't necessarily make sense, by the way. They're just trying to be creative, you know? It's kind of like fashion. It doesn't make sense. It doesn't even necessarily look good, but it's definitely something that pushes creativity. So you can see it coming back to the standard position. It is a little iffy because of the amount of controllers here, but let's press it one more time. So we're gonna see there the blocks separate. They push back in together, and then it like unlocks outward on either side. So this is probably one of my favorite doors that I did build, maybe because it was the most time consuming as well. But let me get the connection tool out. You can actually see, look at this. There are, I guess that's actually 10, 20, 30, 40 pistons on the door itself, not counting the pistons around it to control the rest of the mechanisms. So what's happening though is we're pressing this. Some of the pistons are retracting, but then they all retract together even further, and then the whole thing separates in two. So I really like this one because when it's all together like this, you can't tell where any of the lines are. Now, I did end up using some of the spaceship material that was added, and so it really covers up all of those seams, but you can see when the whole thing actions, it's really smooth, it looks really fantastic, and from the other side here, it's really not exciting at all. Now, door number three. I don't even know if I can actually call it a door necessarily. I mean, it's a form of a door. It lets you go from one space to another, but I guess I'll just let the door speak for itself. So I'll press the switch. There it goes. The whole thing spins around, and look at that, there is a pod for you to get in. So the next thing you have to do, of course, is go into that pod, and there's a switch right above you there. You press that switch, and look at this, guys. There we go. The door rotates around, and we are now on the other side. So this is a really simple door when it comes to how it's made. I ended up putting a bearing on the bottom there with a controller that spins it 180 degrees. So you can see this would be kind of like closing the door or rotating the thing. I don't know. I mean, technically, if you're on the other side and you press this switch, then you would be closing the door on the other side, so the door would have to be called. I don't know. It's a weird door, but I was thinking about this. There's some really, really awesome application for this. So right now I have it set up so that it does 180 degrees like so. So it really kind of fulfills that like straight door that you imagine. But I realized that you could actually put different angular values in the controller and change the door entirely as the way it would function. So instead of rotating like this 180, we could actually have it rotate, say, 90 degrees, and it would open in this direction instead. So this is kind of like a really cool door that you could use for hallways or like a maze or different types of passageways where you don't necessarily want to go from like a full flat surface. You actually might want to exit on a 90 degree angle. So this door was really cool for that because it kind of pushes what a door really is. Now, next up, we've got door number 4. Now, this door is really kind of strange, honestly. I don't know where I was going with it. I wanted to try something different. So there's no switch on this door. This is just like an automatic one that you step up to. I can't really explain it. So I'm just going to let the door speak for itself. So here we go. You walk up right up to it. And there we go. You get this really nice, satisfying, like, passageway opening kind of thing where a bunch of different arms opens up and then you go through it. So this one was kind of like, I was trying to be a little more artistic, but at the same time, I wanted to give it almost like a little bit more of an organic feel. So like, if you imagine, say, like an alien spaceship or something like that, they might have like a really strange door like this that opens up in this really strange manner. But nonetheless, you know, it is still a door. This side here looks really cool, actually. You can see all of the blocks like protruding out on the other side as well. So I think I kind of got close to something like that. Like I said, like a little bit more of an organic feel. And then of course you can close it from this side here. And there it goes, it shuts down just like that. Next up is door number 5, I think. I hope I'm not losing track here. So door number 5, though, is very interesting. Because right now it looks like probably one of the doors we've already seen, right? Maybe the vertical sliding door. It's very, very similar. Or maybe that crazy cube lock pattern as well. But no, this one is completely different, guys. I don't even know if you can even guess what this door is going to do. Is it going to open up? Is it going to open down? Is it going to open sideways? Well, let's find out. Press the switch. And look at that. It's actually a door that is a staircase. Now, you guys might not have even expected that, but this is a really interesting door because it's a door and a staircase at the same time. And of course, you can shut it no problem. And it's really cool because you don't even know. You can't even tell. So imagine, you know, you're like in your friend's base or something like that. And you're like, oh, here's this really interesting door. Let's press that. And the next thing you know, it's a staircase. I think that would be really cool. Now, I don't know exactly how pistons are going to be implemented in survival as far as like a rarity goes. Like in my mind, this could be a colossal waste of pistons in survival potentially. But realistically, it's all just a bunch of pistons pushing out a single bar of these blocks right here. So in design, it's pretty simple, but I think it definitely looks really fantastic, and it's very satisfying to see the lights appear on the left there, which is kind of like guiding your way up the stairs. Now this stair one though, I don't have a switch on the top here. This is more of like an access point where you would just have your stairs and you go up. Now you could probably add some type of cover to the thing once you put it down. You know what? I'm actually kind of curious. Let's see what happens here if we shut the stairs from this side. Ah, look, there you go. You actually have a really good idea of what is going on. Now, this is something, though, like I said, you could put a piston cover here or something just to kind of cover this hole if you did ever want to actually shut the stairs or shut the door. Stairs? Door? I don't know. So moving along, we are now at door number 6. Now this is a very interesting door. This is one of the ideas that I had that kind of sparked this whole idea in my mind of creating different doors and trying to think of different styles that you haven't really seen before. Now this one is another one of my favorites. Also one of the ones that did take quite some time, but let's press the switch here. Open this door. Ah, look at that. So that is really cool. I don't think I've ever really seen a door style like this, but it is like the four panel sliding in on an angled door. It's really cool. I'm really happy with the way it turned out. You can even see we have a ground bottom there. Now this is actually a false bottom on the door. You can see we kind of sink down into it, but the gap is narrow enough that the mechanic doesn't fall in. So it does allow for us to be able to walk through the door, no problem whatsoever. And you can see once we press the switch, those things go right through the base there. But look at that. That thing looks absolutely fantastic. I do like the design and the mismatched patterns of the spacecraft panel as well. So this is a really awesome door. Now, this door is really crazy, though. It took a little bit of work on this one compared to some of the other ones. You can see there is a couple different bearings on each corner here. So basically what's happening is I have those panels turned in with these bearings and then turned in again. Now I guess the easiest way is to really just kind of show you, I would imagine, what that looks like. So there we go, you can see that is a bearing there, and then we have another bearing there to return the panel back to a flat way. So what I ended up doing was measuring 45 degree angles from the center point. So I believe if we get like a block here, actually, we'll be able to see our center point on this door right there, actually. Yeah, so what I ended up doing was I put a bearing here and then created 45 degree angles outward and used that as the center point. Now, one thing that was a little trickier was I did end up having to use a Smart Engine controller. So the Smart Engine controller allowed for me to create very, very specific values on these pistons. So the pistons extend a certain number, I can't remember exactly how many it is, plus a decimal point value as well. So you can see when they come down like this, they meet right in the center there, nice and flush, which is actually on the half block though. You can see if I extend this out right here, you can see the door panels, they're merging right there on the half block. So yeah, this door was definitely a lot of fun to make. I'm really satisfied with the way it turned out. Now, clearly, it is not a very practical door. Like, the amount of space this door takes up is absolutely ridiculous. But like a compact version of this would be really awesome. But I don't think this is something we would ever use in survival, simply because of the fact that it takes up so much space. So it would just be a more of a liability than anything. So here we are now at door number 7. Now this door looks pretty normal to me, you know, like a wooden panel door, simple handle there, nothing all that crazy. But if you try and open the door, oh, you can see we actually get dropped down. So this isn't a standard door. This is a trapdoor, which, I mean, technically is still a door, right? So this was kind of like a bit of an idea that I had where it was kind of like, you know, maybe you could have like a false base or a fake base. And if you're playing online on like multiplayer servers, someone might come to your base and try and sneak in or break in. They see the doors right there, you know, there's no guards, there's nothing protecting it. So they try and just go right into your base, but instead they get dropped down into something like maybe a pit. I don't even know. I can't even speculate what they would fall in because I don't know what will be in survival, but I feel like there is potential for a way to hurt people in multiplayer. So you could put like a spud gun trap down there, or maybe there will be spikes or something. And so you could kind of, you know, get a little bit of retribution from someone trying to break into your base. So here we are, door number 8. Now this one, I'm gonna kind of have some fun with it. I'm not gonna say what the door is based off of. It's not a complicated door, it's not a crazy door, but it's more so just about some elegant design. But what I want from you guys is down in the comments, let me know, what door is this from? What does this door look familiar to you? Does it ring any bells? If it does, let me know what you think this door is from. But now, using the door itself is quite simple. We have a handle here right in the middle of the door. You press it, and there we go. It opens up to the next space. And you can walk right through that little tiny hole, which is actually very good for little mechanics, isn't it? And then of course you can shut it from this side here, no problem whatsoever. Bada bing, bada boom. It's just a bearing, but it's more about the design here, guys. So again, let me know down in the comments, what is this door from? And now it is time for probably the most epic door out of all of these doors. This is the Extreme Sci-Fi door. It's got a very robust feel to it. It looks really strong and sturdy, ready for space travel or some type of very intense base or building. So I think this might be something that could be really cool to have in survival, minus the fact that it might not be the most efficient when it comes to using your parts and pieces. But let me press the switch here, guys, just so you can see what this door is all about. There we go. Look at that. It happens really fast. But you can see that the door is three separate panels that opens and closes all together just like so. Now, the actual mechanical function of the door is quite simple, guys. We've got a piston on either side on the bottom and then one at the top, which is very similar to the vertical sliding door. So this is kind of like a variation of that. It's the vertical sliding door with two horizontal sliding doors as well, and they kind of meet in the middle there in like a pattern. Now, this was actually pretty interesting to build and really difficult to build because I decided to use little tiny surface panels. I think you guys can see it right there. There are surface panels that go around the perimeter of each of those door segments, and that just added a really nice touch of detail, but it caused a lot of problems in terms of trying to actually have the door function, simply because of the friction points from these surface panels on the blocks on the side. So what I ended up doing was I turned all of these here. You can see there's a whole bunch. It goes all the way around. It goes even, I think, farther back here in some points as well. These are all reduced collision blocks. Now, the reduced collision block is a fantastic block for certain applications like this, simply because it allows for certain things to kind of rub up against them, and it doesn't actually touch the object. Now, a great way for me to show you this, actually, would be to get a block out here just like so. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to drop this block on to the reduced collision block, and you guys are going to get a good idea of how much there is of a reduction. And look at that, guys. You can see right there, that is the reduced collision, and that is what allows for the door to freely pass behind these blocks, despite the fact that you can actually see them sticking into the block. So yeah, this is the epic sci-fi door, one of my favorites. Love the way it turned out, love the way it looks, and I would honestly, like, if I had like a whole space base that had these doors all around it, I think I'd be feeling pretty good. And so door number 10 is just a giant empty space that you can walk out through. No, I'm just kidding. That's not what it is. There is no door number 10, but there's a really good reason why. And that is because I'm reaching out to you guys. I want you to make your coolest, craziest, most creative door that you can imagine and send it to me so I can check them out and do a video on doors that were submitted by you guys. So on the screen, there is an email right there, so make sure you save your creation as Door Moonbow, or put something in your creation name. Send me the workshop link. Make sure it's set to public as well. Make sure you list any mods that are necessary. Otherwise, if I can't spawn it in the world, then there's a really good chance that it won't show up in a video. So yeah, so send me your doors, your most creative doors, and I will pick my favorites and showcase them in a future video. I'm really looking forward to seeing what crazy doors you guys might come up with, because I thought I was pretty creative, but I know there's going to be some even crazier things out there. And now to finish the video, here are all of the doors in a sequence so we can actually experience them in real time, nice and fast. There's the vertical sliding door. There we go. Here is the crazy block, unlock, unhinge, crazy door. I really love that one. And then of course we do have the turnstile door, which was mentioned before that you can use it for 90 degree doors, 180 degree doors, or if you want to just spin them around and have them come out the same way again, why not? And then we have the weird organic door with the arms that kind of extend out. This is kind of a weird door. Like I said, I don't know exactly what I was thinking. And then we have the stair door. This is the door that opens up and becomes stairs. Really think that is awesome. And this here, of course, is the four panel door that opens up in a circle. And then we have the door that looks like a door, but it's actually a trap door. And then we've got the mystery door here. Still wondering, guys. Make sure you let me know down in the comments what the heck that door is from. And then we have the epic sci-fi door with the three panels opening up and close it down just like so. So that is going to be today's video, guys. I sure hope it did inspire you with your door making. I'm really looking forward to seeing what doors you guys send to me. Again, the email is on the screen there if you want to send your workshop links my way, and I will definitely check them out. So thank you so much for tuning in to Endless Scrap Mechanic, guys. If you did enjoy the video, then let me know by hitting that like button. If you want to find some more Endless Scrap Mechanic, then be sure to subscribe to the channel, maybe even turn on some notifications so you can get the latest and the craziest coming from me in Scrap Mechanic. So guys, thank you so much for tuning in, and I will see you in the next one. So bye for now.